So where are we going right now, Rudra?
We'll probably go up this hill. Looks quite cleared. We can get some good viewpoints there.
Having just rubbed noses with the monsoon in Kerala, we moved on to Goa in the hopes of catching a proper monsoon rendezvous. We were joined by the third story hunter, Rudra, who insofar had only been with us in spirit. He joined us full of excitement, and before we even got a chance to do a proper introduction, he had already scampered up the mountain in search of a good viewpoint. We had no choice but to desperately try and catch up to him.
Make him stop, man. Can't walk anymore. Prashant, make Rudra stop. It's too much.
I don't know where the fuck he's gone.
Okay, Rudra has reached the top of the hill and he's given us the okay. That means that there's a good vantage point. You can shoot some good stuff. I'm just gonna shoot way more time lapses so that we can just rest.
Okay, a quick diversion. No, wait, what? Okay, so a quick diversion.
Man, fuck you.
Yo, come on, buddy.
Oh no,
we can go up also more, but I think
this is... I need to shoot some time lapses very urgently. So if I could choose a thumbnail for the entire series, this is what it would look like. Chasing the monsoons.
Yeah.
You're on top of a hill in Goa where the monsoons have already hit, apparently.
No, today.
They're supposed to hit today as... like every other day on this trip. And this is us, man. Look at the sun, the heat.
Hot, so hot.
Just waiting for water, shooting time lapses. What is this? Where are the monsoons?
Should we go to the beach, maybe?
The number of beaches we waited at. Been
man.
Stood up at.
Let's not wait, let's just swim.
Alright, let's have a swim break.
Famished from that trek up the hill and the subsequent swim to drown our sorrows, we headed to meet Rudra's friend Luis, who ran a popular restaurant called Pink Chili. We were curious about how local businesses prepped for the season, and as luck would have it, they were bang in the middle of monsoon prep.
I moved to India in 2007. I used to work for a record company for EMI Music, and then eventually I made a move over here full-time after leaving work. We basically started Pink Chili in 2012, and the rest is history. I think for most of the restaurants that are functioning and running in off-season, there is business. The take-up on home deliveries is bigger. We have a lot of boys that are running around in raincoats. Monsoon is growing every year in Goa.
Not wanting to come in the way of the monsoon prep, we left them to it and moved on. On our agenda next was Rudra's friend Uday, who lived on an island on the banks of the Mandovi River. So we hopped on to the next ferry and set off.
I've never been on a ferry before.
Neither have I. Safe to say, I'm fucking scared.
We were headed to a part of Goa unknown to most tourists who visit here. Salim Ali Bird Sanctuary in Chorao Island is a bird watcher's paradise. And as we would later find out, humans weren't the only ones doing the bird watching.
Okay, nice to meet you. My name is Uday Mandrekar. I born on this island, Chorao Island. Chorao is the name of the Portuguese town, but now is a local name, it's called Sudan.
You're called the birdman of Chorao famously.
Yeah.
The original birdman is Dr. Salim Ali. Could you tell us a little bit about this bird sanctuary that's named after
him? This sanctuary started in 1986 on the name of the Dr. Salim Ali. He's the first bird watcher of India. I started over here in 1990. I like the birds and nature and all. When I'm going to school, that time I started. Sometime I'm bummed for the school also. I didn't went in the school. I'm going for the trip for the bird watching for the with the people like foreigners and all over there. And a lot of people are coming from all over the cross of the world, like England, America, Germany, France. Only not the money, not everything. I like the people also to share with each other, talking and all over there. We have also a lot of crocodiles. We want to spot the crocodile, the special places of them. We can see them in the low tide only. Yeah, they come on the sitting on the bank of water and under the tree and the shadow also. And we're getting very close over there.
This was an opportunity too good to pass up. Now that Uday had teased us with the idea, we wanted to get up close with those crocs. And it wasn't long before.
Alright, we're in the boat and there is a crocodile right next to us doing some crocodile spotting. Can you see him? Good, a few minutes of good.
Yeah, I can't see him. You have to stay extremely quiet because crocodiles don't like human voices.
They don't like, yeah, they're generally silent animals, they like don't like to party. I like to call it an early evening, read a book, go to bed, and take naps. And this is the nap time.
Oh, we see another one. Another one. Right there. Beach or apocalypse now vibes. Okay, 70% apocalypse now vibes, but there's no war going on.
Success! We had managed to capture these majestic beasts on film and we were so stoked. Even Uday couldn't contain his excitement.
So when we're 5 foot of the crocodile and we're not going in for the kill,
by which I mean this could turn out pretty badly, I just didn't see the sense in that. I was looking at a rare crazy, you know those random tips we heard? Make yourself look bigger, stuff, and three of us going in.
But with a crocodile, you're supposed to run zigzag.
Yeah, to escape. Yeah. I'm not escaping for my life, no Ravi. Oh, the croc is most likely escaping for his life.
Happily assumed. Crocodile is scared of him.
I'm coming for you.
And before this, you say, look at the confidence of the crocodile. Like, crocodile, I can eat you. You can be moving around me.
When Udayji was like, maybe don't go there. I'm not coming there.
Yeah.
I'm definitely not. You test this out yourself. I was like, let's come. Also, the second my foot hit the water, I'm like, wait. I know nothing about this water. I know about that guy over there.
Side
I know nothing about this guy here.
And you only spelled out that strategy, remember?
Yeah.
There's one laying out of humans at my head, the second one attacks from the back.
Yeah. Shit.
Besides the fact that we hadn't seen a drop of rain, it was a fairly successful day overall. And we headed down to the ice cream parlor to celebrate with Luis's son, Mali. On the next episode of Chasing the Monsoon.
I used to go swimming there, you know.
Oh yeah?
Till I saw a few crocs lying in the sand.
So did we, yeah.
It's just that feeling that you're swimming in somewhere below you, a crocodile.
It's raining, finally.
Rudra, I think we've actually done it.
Might have done it.